Okay, Michael.
Very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much again for joining us in our Saturday Zoom. I'm glad that you guys take some time to listen to our Zoom webinar. So today I will talk about partner visa. So just excuse me a little bit because my background. I just arrived at LA last Saturday. Yeah, I'm in quarantine right now, so I'm in a hotel quarantine. It's kind of a good experience to be back to Australia. And once I landed, there were policemen everywhere, and we are taken up into the bus and straight into the hotel. And here I'm in a quarantine in Adelaide. So everything is keeping up well. So let me start the presentation. I will change to the PowerPoint. So with me is my colleague Kay. So Kay will be speaking in Mandarin. Right, Kay, can you see Kay?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So my topic today will be on partner visa. Right? So this visa, how does it work? Before I start in, I just have a quick introduction. So myself is Michael Yong. I'm a registered migration agent. My colleague, Ms. Kay, she's a consultant. So she'll be assisting me in the translation in Mandarin. So a bit of myself, I'm a registered migration agent where my license is given by Immigration Department of Home Affairs in Australia. I also have a license for New Zealand Immigration Advisor, and I've been practicing the migration advisory for the last 10 years. Okay, just let me come into today's topic on partner visa. So this visa is for who? You may qualify for a partner visa if you are engaged, married, or in a de facto relationship with an Australian citizen, Australia permanent resident, or eligible New Zealand citizen. So partner visa has a few options. So today I will share with you three of the options for partner visa. So it all depends on your situation, whether you are in a relationship, you are in a de facto, you are engaged, or you are married, and the length of relationship and the location where you are presently.
OK, 今天呢我们要分享的呢是澳洲配偶的签证。那么澳洲配偶签证呢它其实有分为好几种类别的。那么首先呢你要如何申请配偶签证这个类别呢，那么前提非常关键的就是你的配偶，你的另一半必须要是澳洲公民或者澳洲的永久居民，再或者符合条件的新西兰公民。那么呢你们前提你们必须要是订婚的关系、结婚的关系或者是实际的关系。实际关系在英文我们叫做 de facto relationship。澳洲呢它是承认这个关系的。那么刚刚我说了嘛，澳洲的配偶签证呢它有分成好几种类别。那么这个就要取决于申请人当时的情况。如果当时申请人仍是在境外的话，那么他就要申请境外的签证咯。如果是境内的，那么就申请境内的，以此类推。
Type of partner visa. So today I will talk about three pathways. One is the prospective marriage visa, subclass 300. And there's another part, partner visa, subclass 820 and 801, which I'll explain to you the difference between onshore. And another one is the offshore visa, subclass 309 and 100. So why there are two subclasses? When I move on to the next slide, I'll explain to you.
OK, 澳洲的配偶签证呢，它会根据申请人当时的情况来决定于你到底是适合申请哪一种类别的配偶签证。那么它总共有分为三大类。那么首先第一类呢是准结婚签证，就是你跟你配偶之间是还没有结婚的，还不是夫妻关系的，那么你们可能可以透过这类型的签证来获得配偶签证。第二类呢就是属于境内的配偶签证，那么它的代号叫做820跟801。 那820跟801到底有什么区别呢？我们等一下稍后会再解释。好，那之后呢，最后一个类别是境外的配偶签证。境外呢，顾名思义就是海外的人，他申请，他人不在澳洲，他人在海外，可能在马来西亚或中国或其他国家的，那他可以申请这类型的境外签证，他的代号是301跟100。
Alright, the first visa I'll talk about will be the prospective marriage visa.
好，第一个我们要分享的是准结婚签证，代号300。
Okay, this visa is the situation where you are currently overseas, which means you are outside Australia, and you have a relationship, a partner who is an Australian citizen or Australia permanent resident or eligible New Zealand citizen. So this particular visa is apply offshore, which means you are still at your home country, right? You put in the application, and when the department grant you the visa, you actually were allowed to enter into Australia, all right, to get married. So you're given 9 months from the visa grant date, all right, to be in Australia and to get married. So once you are married, then the next pathway for you is to apply a partner visa for you to stay in Australia. And that will lead you to a permanent resident. So the visa that you're going for will be the first application will be a Subclass 820. And then after 2 years later, you will be given an application for Subclass 801. That is going to be your permanent resident visa. So why are they two particular subclass? Because when you come to Australia, first as a prospective marriage, then you get married. And after that, we can lodge in a partner visa for you. Initially, they will give you a 2 years partner visa subclass 820. And at the end of 2 years, the department will basically send an email saying that now you can apply for your permanent resident visa, which is subclass 801. So what is the condition for this visa? So the applicant and the spouse must be physically met and in person and have known each other. So there's a genuine intention for you to live together as a married couple. And very importantly, both of you must be over 18 years old. So the sponsor, which is your partner in Australia, all right, must not have previously sponsored another partner in the last 5 years.
OK，我们来先解释一下第一种签证，叫做准结婚证，代号300。好，那么我们来解释一下这个签证到底有些什么特别，然后它的一些注解都有些哪些呢？这类型的签证呢，它的另一半呢，同样的必须要是澳洲的公民、永久居民或者是符合资格的新西兰公民。然后呢，这类型的签证呢，是双方还没有注册结婚的。然后呢，海外的申请人呢，他有意向想要抵达澳洲，跟他澳洲的另一半结婚。那么呢，通常呢，申请人是可以直接申请这个300的签证。然后呢，这个签证当他一批之后呢，在9个月里面，申请人跟担保人，就是他的澳洲的另一半，必须要举办婚礼。然后在举办婚礼之后的，在这个时间段呢，必须要申请820或801。820跟801是境内的配偶签证，因为你人已经在境内了嘛，对吧？那你就可以申请境内的配偶签证。那么这类型的申请呢，它的条规呢，它是申请人跟担保人之间呢，必须要是彼此见过面的。现在很流行一些网恋哦，就是网上的一些恋爱啊。那么你们是没有见过面的，那你又想要申请这个准结婚证的话呢，基本上呢，拒签率是会很高的。那么我们会相对的，我们会建议你们申请人跟担保人之间呢是有见过面的，然后彼此有合过影啊，或者是有去过其他旅行什么的。那么呢，你们可以提供这些证据来申请这个300的签证。然后呢，你们这一个夫妻，这个即将成为的夫妻呢，你们必须要有共同的目标，然后想要以夫妻的关系是生活在一起的。然后担保人跟申请人的年龄呢，必须要是18岁以上。成年嘛，18岁以上。然后最重要的一点就是，担保人在过去的5年里面呢，不曾担保超过一个伴侣。
The next visa I'll talk about is the onshore visa. So onshore means you as an applicant must be inside Australia to apply. So this partner visa is subclass 820 and subclass 801.
好，第二类型的配偶签证，我们要介绍的是境内的配偶签证，就是申请人人在澳洲境内提交申请表，那么它的代号是 820 跟 801。
So this partner visa subclass 820 and 801 is for applicants who are already in a relationship, right? So which means you already have a relationship with an Australian citizen, a permanent resident, or eligible New Zealand citizen who is living in Australia. And eight subclass visa starting with 8 are usually onshore visa, which means the main applicant must be already inside Australia. So this visa, the subclass 802, when you first apply for the visa, you'll be given a 24 months validity of the visa. So after 24 months, then you'll be eligible to apply for the permanent visa, which is the subclass 801. So what will happen is that at the end of the 24 months, there is a set of criteria you must satisfy. The relationship needs to be ongoing. And if it's not ongoing, there are certain exceptional circumstances, usually it's domestic violence, that you can still apply for the subclass 801. But if the relationship fall off within the period of 24 months, you cannot move on to apply for a permanent resident. So both applicant and the spouse have to be in de facto relationship for at least 12 months. So which means you have to have a history of a relationship in the last 12 months. And what are the criteria for them to assess you on your relationship? In my subsequent slide, I will explain that to you because that particular clause will be similarly for onshore and offshore visa. So in terms of age, you must be over 18. So in circumstances where you already have a child or a very long-term relationship and both of you have a child or children, all right, they may grant you straight away a subclass 801, which means you will get a permanent resident first, you know, instead of going through a 2 year period. And this visa must be lodged onshore. Yeah? And during this time, when the visa is lodged, right, the applicant, right, must be in Australia. And when a decision is made, you also must be in Australia. And for the permanent resident situation, you can be in or outside Australia.
OK， 然后我们第二类型要解释的呢，就是境内的配偶签证。那么境内的配偶签证呢，它跟刚刚的准结婚证到底有哪些区别呢？那么我们来看一下。那首先呢，它第一个呢，就是它的硬性条件，就是你的配偶今天，如果你是申请人的话，你的另一半呢，必须要是澳洲的公民，澳洲的永久居民，或者是符合资格的新西兰公民。这个是硬性条件，这是改变不了的。 好，那么呢之后呢，820跟80要之间有什么区别呢？就是这类型的签证呢，它是属于申请人必须要抵达澳洲之后申请的。你可以当时是领着旅游签证还是学生签证抵达澳洲之后，你再提交申请。那么820呢是通常移民局会先批给你的，它是一个临时的伴侣签证，就是让你可以合法的居住在澳洲，然后和你的另一半团圆。因为澳洲呢它是很 注重于家庭团圆这一块的，所以他通常都会先给你个820，让你住在澳洲跟你的先生或者是跟你的太太团圆。然后呢，之后呢，在24个月之后呢，你可以再提交一个801的永久配偶签证。好，那么要注意一下，就是配偶跟申请人之间的关系呢，必须要长达12个月以上。这个关系呢，是通常是给予一些 申请人跟担保人之间，他们是没有婚姻关系的，他们并不是结婚的太太和丈夫，他们是属于一种叫做 de facto 的 relationship， 这是一种实际上的关系。因为澳洲也承认这类型的关系，但是前提是必须要维持超过12个月以上。当你在提交820签证的时候，然后呢，他的申请人呢，申请人跟担保人的年龄呢，也必须要是成年的。澳洲的成年年龄是18岁以上。 好，那么通常呢，大多数的情况下，移民局会是会先批820，之后两年之后再转的，再转801。但是也有小部分的申请人，他是直接可以获得801的。那么怎么获得801呢？在通常的情况下啦，就是申请人跟担保人之间呢，他们有共同的孩子。 那么孩子就是有血缘关系嘛，那么有血缘关系的话呢，移民局呢，他那么注重家庭这一块的话呢，他会直接大多数的情况下，他会是直接批你801的，所以在这方面你就是占了优势，然后也替你省下了很多时间。好，那么呢，我们来说一下801、820的它的条件都有哪些呢？它的提交条件呢，既然还是境内的申请嘛。 那么它的提交条件就是人必须要在境内，申请人当时的情况必须要在境内，然后呢，在结果出炉的那一瞬间，你也要在境内。那么在审核的过程当中，你是可以进出澳洲没有任何限制，但是在结果的那一天，你必须要在境内。好，那么801呢，它是一个永久的配偶签证，那么呢，它就没有这方面的条件。 就是801呢，你在审核的过程当中，还有在审核的结果呢，你人在境内、境外都可以。All
right, and the third visa, for the partner visa, this is an offshore visa, subclass 309 and 100. Offshore means you must be outside Australia.
好，我们第三个要介绍的配偶签证呢是。 境外的配偶签证，它的代号呢是 301跟 100。
Partner visa subclass 309 and 100. Now this is the offshore visa, which means you must be outside Australia. So usually the circumstances is that the applicant already has a relationship, right? Or they may have already married or in a de facto relationship. With an Australian citizen, permanent resident, or eligible New Zealand citizen. So with this visa, it will allow you to obtain a 2 years partner visa for you to move into Australia. So to apply for, you apply when you start the application, when you first start the application, you basically will apply for both the visa. Sorry, yeah. Let me just go back to the slide. Okay, so you apply for both the permanent and temporary visa at the same time. So the temporary partner, which is a provisional visa subclass 309, is granted first, and that allows you to stay in Australia for 2 years, while the permanent partner visa will be in process, which is a subclass 100. So both applicant and the spouse has to be in de facto relationship for at least 12 months. And again, the minimum age is 18 years old. Obviously, you have to be independent. And in certain circumstances, you may be granted a subclass 100, which is a permanent visa straight away, if you have a long-term relationship with your partner and there is a child in that relationship. So this application, you must be outside Australia when you lodge your visa application. And the decision, when the decision of the visa to be granted, you must be also outside Australia. So once the visa grant, you will hold a subclass 309. Now, there are circumstances where we have done application where the main applicant already have children, right? And that children could be from a previous relationship, right? So if that children are under the dependent age, they can be also included in the same application. So which means once you apply, the main applicant will get a subclass 309 and all the children that is dependent will also get the same subclass 309. Then when you move to Australia or when you still continue your relationship with your partner, whether you are inside or outside Australia, after 2 years, all right, you will be given an opportunity to apply for a permanent resident subclass 100. So this is going to be a permanent resident visa. So at the time when this application is given to you, the relationship must be ongoing.
OK, 然后我们最后一个要介绍的签证就是境外的配偶签证。 那么，顾名思义，境外就是你人是在海外的，你人不在澳洲境内的，那么你也可以提交配偶签证，因为不是每一个申请人他们都会待在澳洲境内提交的，他们有的时候呢，他们可能在他们自己本身的国家，在马来西亚或在其他国家，可能他们有自己要顾及的自己的事业啊、生意啊，还是有家庭的牵绊等等的，所以他们可能他们无法一直留在澳洲等待签证的。 结果，那么呢，他们是可以选择境外配偶签证这一条的。那么境外配偶签证呢，它的那个代号呢是309跟100。那么309跟100有什么区别呢？我等等再做解释。那么我现在先说一下到底啊、这类型的境外签证它的一些啊、硬性条件都有哪些呢？那么一样的啊、配偶签证呢，境外的配偶签证，你的另一半呢也是必须要是澳洲的公民、澳洲的永久签证或者是一些符合资格的新西兰公民的。然后呢，你今天你提交境外的配偶签证呢，移民局呢会先暂时批你一个309的。309呢，它就是一个临时的签证，它就刚刚跟境内的820是一样道理了，就是说澳洲移民局呢会先批你一个临时的签证，然后让你抵达澳洲跟你的另一半团圆的，因为你申请309是在境外嘛，对吧？然后呢，你再领着这个309的签证抵达境内，然后再提交100签证，因为100呢是永久的伴侣签证。好，那么呢，如果你今天呢，你跟你的另一半呢，他的关系呢是属于 de facto 的 relationship， 就是一个实际的关系，但是又不是夫妻关系的话呢，那么同样的，你跟你的担保人的关系呢，必须要维持超过12个月以上。好，那么呢，双方呢也必须要是成年的年龄，就是18岁以上。那么呢，同样的，如果你今天呢啊，多数的申请人呢、啊，他们通常都会先批一个309，之后再批100，但是也有少数的申请人呢，他们是直接可以获批100的。那么如何获得100的申请呢？就是呢，申请人跟配偶之间呢，通常都有一个连带关系，就是他们一个孩子，就是孩子是共同的，然后有血缘关系的。通常呢，这类型的签证呢，有加一个孩子的话呢，签证的下批呢，通常他都会直接给你100签证，就是直接是绿卡了，让你抵达澳洲之后呢，就直接是绿卡了。好，那么呢，这个309呢，它的硬性条件是在于呢，申请跟结果出炉的那一刹那呢，你必须要人在境外的。你在申请的过程当中，你可以拿着旅游签或者是其他签证抵达澳洲跟你的另一半团圆，这个是没有关系的。但是在申请提交的那一瞬间，还有申请结果的那一瞬间呢，你人必须要是在境外就对了。好，那么签证100呢，它是一个绿卡的签证嘛，那么呢，它就没有这方面的条件。你在签证100的时候呢，你人在境内境外都无所谓的。
Okay, now this night is a common criteria for the partner visa. So I will go in line by line. All right, if you are in a relationship and you are you are a married couple, right? So if you are a married couple, you basically need to demonstrate that you and your spouse must show both committed to share life together, excluding all others. So which means it has to be a genuine relationship. There are requirements where you need to prove that you are living together and you must be married and is valid under Australian law. So in general, in these circumstances, usually we will ask the client to provide your shared address, your common address, your mailing address. So we will basically ask your mails. And then in terms of sharing your common life together, you'll be requesting you in terms of your finance, in terms of how you present yourself to your family member, how you present yourself to the community. So if you are in a de facto relationship, right? So you and your partner are in de facto relationship, and you are not married to each other, your relationship is genuine and continue, and you must live together and do not live separately apart on a permanent basis, and you must not be related by family. So this de facto partner visa is basically for people who are not married and they already have a relationship for the last 12 months. So again, the requirement for relationship, there is a checklist which we will provide to you for us to prepare a document to prove all the points that I've just shared with you. So usually the de facto relationship must be existing for at least 12 months immediately before you apply for the visa. So time spent dating, you know, or in an online relationship are not counted as a de facto relationship. So it's very important that you basically have a trail of 12 months of document to show that you've been living together and you have a commitment to share life together. So there is a list of documents that we will provide you a checklist to provide. So in circumstances where we have applicant that comes in that they do not have more than 12 months of relationship, basically we will ask you not to start the application until you have completed the 12 months of relationship. So there are circumstances where if you are less than 12-month relationship, if you have compelling and compassionate circumstances exist for the grant of subclass 802 visa, which is onshore. So if you have that compelling and compassionate circumstances, there are possibility for you to apply if you are less than 12 months.
OK, 那我们现在解释一下配偶签证它如何见证就是申请人跟担保人之间到底有没有符合关系证明这一块呢？好，那么我们先说一下就是已婚的申请人，就是今天你跟你的配偶之间，你跟你的担保人之间，你们的关系是属于已婚的，属于合法的夫妻的。那么要如何证明你们是属于合法夫妻呢？那么第一个很重要的就是你们是已经结婚了嘛？那么你们的婚姻呢，必须要是符合澳洲的法律的。 好，那么呢，第二个呢，就是你们有共同的生活，然后呢，你们可以提供相关的资料，比如说你们一起去旅游啊，然后你们一起出行啊，还是一起你们有共同住在同一个地址的一些证明的，就比如说一些银行流水单，然后一些可能一些电费、水费、煤气费等等的。 好，那之后呢，你们必须要证明你们的关系是真诚，并且是持续的。你们不可以说今天你们结婚了，但是你们是离婚的状态，那是不成立的。因为澳洲移民局它是很注重于在于就是你们的关系是真诚还有持续的这一块的。 好，那么呢，最好就是你跟配偶之间呢，你们是长期是住在一起的，或者是可能你们是分隔两地，但是很多时候都会互相飞去对方的国家居住一段时间，那这方面呢会非常的好。 我们不建议申请人就是天隔一方，就是说可能你跟你的配偶是住在一个不一样的国家，然后呢长期是没有见面或者是长期是没有互相联络的。那如果是这种情况呢，拒签率是会非常高的。好，那么我们来说一下第二种的配偶他的关系。 澳洲移民局呢，它除了承认已婚的状态之外呢，它还承认一个状态叫做实际配偶，就是 de facto relationship，就是今天你跟你配偶之间呢是没有结婚的，但是你们在一起是超过12个月的，然后呢你们也承认彼此的关系，然后最重要的一点就是你们的关系是真实并且是持续的，这个非常的重要。 然后呢，最重要的另外一点就是你们不可以是家人的关系哦，因为这个是不被承认的。之后最后一个就是你们是最好是同住在一个城市，或者是你们可能住在不一样国家，但是就是很多时候你们都会互相飞去对方的国家，一起生活的。然后呢，你们可以提供以下的证明，就是说可能你们可以提供。 飞机票证明说你们互相飞去对方的国家见对方，然后展示出入境的记录，然后还有就是可能可以提供一些在一起居住的一些硬性的一些条件，比如说你们可能是住在一起的一些地址啊，然后一些水电煤单啊等等的。好，那么我来说一下就是defect relationship。 defect relationship 这一块呢，你们的关系必须要长达12个月以上。就是如果今天你们没有结婚，但是你想要申请配偶签证，你想要用 defect 这个关系来申请的话呢，它是承认的，它是被移民局承认的，但是前提是必须要超过12个月以上。然后如果你们是属于线上的约会啊 ，online 的 dating 啊，还是你们可能很少见面的话呢，那么基本上呢这。 它的时间段呢，可能不被澳洲承认的，它可能会要求你们提供更多的资料，证明说你们的关系是真诚的。好，那么呢，一小部分的人呢，可能你可以不用提供12个月的证明的，然后也可以获得820的签证的。那么呢，通常呢，这方面的概率呢，它的成功概率是非常之低的，除非你可以提供一些实际的理由，令人信服的理由。 证明说你们的关系是真诚，并且是持续的，就算没有超过12个月，但是你们的关系是你们之间的关系是非常非常的真诚的。 那但通常我们都不太建议申请人在申请配偶签证是少过12个月的，我们通常都会建议你超过12个月之后呢，再提交申请也不迟。
All right, thank you very much, Kay. I'm always delighted to have Kay to translate. Her Mandarin is very good, and I hope you have a good time with us. So what is next? We basically end our presentation. Do like our Facebook. Myself and Kay, we will have a weekly webinar, and we will put it live on the Facebook. We'll try to cover as much visa as possible. So today is our visa on the family category, and in the family category there are many streams. So today is our first stream, which is a partner visa. There is other stream like last remaining relative, and there's also a stream for parent visa and child visa. So I will cover all this live Zoom, over the Zoom, over the live Facebook, and I will share it with you all every week. So with that, I will show you the last slide, which I will contact. If you guys have any interest or any question regarding about partner visa or anything about Australia migration visa, do speak to other contact below. K contact is also mentioned there. Do contact us from all this mobile number. You can reach us through our email and also through our Facebook. So again, thank you very much for your time, and I wish you to have a good weekend ahead. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.